UW-Madison researchers and students are celebrating their discovery of a brand new species of dinosaur. Catherine Merck shows us how the recently published findings from a dig more than a decade ago are now reshaping our understanding about the age of the dinosaurs.
For paleontologist David Lovelace,
it is a lot of nothing.
Most days are spent drilling down to the details.
For every hour in the field, it usually is about 20 hours in the lab.
He works at the University of Wisconsin Geology Museum.
I'm a grad student here.
Alongside Aaron Kuffner.
There's other days where it's a lot of writing or just a lot of reading and then revising what I've already written because it was completely wrong.
It takes a lot of effort to uncover fossils beyond just what's in the dirt.
But then you have to go back and you fix it. That's all there is to it.
Through this program, students can spend days across the country trying to learn more about the land where dinosaurs once roamed.
The goal was never to go out and find a dinosaur. It was actually to understand the ecosystem and, importantly, why fossils are not preserved there nearly as well as they are other places in the western U.S.
In 2013, students from this lab were analyzing land in Wyoming when a whole lot of nothing.
Finding small bones is actually really hard.
Eventually led them to something.
They're like, what is this bone? And we're like, that's a dinosaur bone. Whoa, okay, everybody stop, let's take a second. Okay, that's pretty cool. Okay, let's find more.
You can imagine the excitement this excavation created.
I never expected to find something like this, nor did I really expect it to have quite the impact that it does on the scientific story of dinosaur evolution.
But there's a catch.
This is it.
The bone that was discovered is smaller than your pinky finger. Lovelace and Kuffner spent years digging into its background.
Because we have so little material of this animal, we had to do a lot of comparisons with like some very specific parts of the anatomy to try to figure out what it is and what it's related to.
They found out the fossil is 230 million years old. It would have stood about a foot tall and 3 feet long with feathers on its body.
It changes how we perceive the origins of dinosaurs.
The published findings that came out this year indicate that dinosaurs inhabited the northern hemisphere millions of years earlier than previously thought.
A small little bone, and it has a pretty big impact, which I find absolutely thrilling.
Its name combines its age and the land of the Shoshone people where it was found.
Avetum banduivici, which is long ago dinosaur.
In other words, this tiny bone now gets a massive title.
It's the oldest dinosaur bone in North America, potentially the Northern Hemisphere.
These scientists find it fascinating that something from so far in the past could impact the future of their field.
It creates probably more questions than it actually answered, but that's the beauty of science.
This rock-solid find will lead to more to be done at the lab.
It really has been a 10-year story arc. From the time of discovery to the time of publication.
It's just the work that we have to do. So it doesn't really feel like it's an amazing thing, but I'm just like, yeah, and then I have to move on to the next thing or I'm not gonna graduate.
Just like the fossils themselves, these paleontologists are thinking long-term.
We're going to go investigate all over the world, I'm sure, to find more of these animals to try to better understand kind of their early evolution.